Well, Thanksgiving is a time to share, and community dinners are planned across the Central Coast. A tremendous, tremendous amount of work goes into putting on these dinners. In Santa Cruz, Friends of Thanksgiving volunteers have been preparing for the big feast since July. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live in Santa Cruz with our story tonight.
Well, that's right, Aaron. This has really become a community event. Friends of Thanksgiving secured the Santa Cruz Civic Auditorium for the second year, creating a welcoming atmosphere for anyone who wants to show up for a Thanksgiving meal or to volunteer. It's crowded in the Santa Cruz Bible Church kitchen, filled with volunteers who are chopping up squash, 300 pounds of it, preparing 1,475 pounds of turkey. Just some of the chores before the Thanksgiving meals are served up. For this chef, preparing food for so many isn't that different than serving up a meal at a restaurant.
It doesn't differ too much. It's just the scale is larger. We put the same love and the same technique as a regular restaurant. It's just more of it.
These are just a handful of 250 volunteers who plan to make a difference this Thanksgiving, whether it's preparing meals for the needy or making time for others who don't want to be alone during the holiday.
I used to think I did it because it made me feel good or made me look good, but no, it's just the right thing to do. I don't know. It's important that we give back.
Just the satisfaction of being able to know there's going to be food on the table for lots of people tomorrow that wouldn't have had it otherwise.
While volunteers prepare the food, it's business and organizations countywide which have donated food or provided their services, which has always made this a successful community event.
Companies have just been so gracious, again, all the way into Watsonville, they've donated to this community event, which is actually a county event, because we just don't want to say it's, you know, just for Santa Cruz, but it's for the county of Santa Cruz, and everyone's welcome.
With that in mind, the Santa Cruz Civic is being turned into the largest dining hall in town this Thanksgiving.
We want to make this a really elegant event for people. I mean, it's like inviting people into our home for a Thanksgiving meal, and so that's the kind of feeling that we like to have.
And if you don't want to sit around and watch football all day, you're more than welcome to volunteer your time at tomorrow's big Thanksgiving feast, Aaron.
This is a ton of work, just a ton of work. Thank you, Phil. The doors open at noon at the Santa Cruz Civic Auditorium, and they'll be feeding people up until 3 o'clock. Last year, they fed 1,000 people. This year, they're expecting more because of the economy.
Throughout the Central Coast today, the rush was on to make sure families in need have food for tomorrow. In Sand City, a very busy day for the Salvation Army as workers handed out gift certificates and turkeys to about 800 families. Gift cards purchased by the Salvation Army so families can buy Thanksgiving fixings. The turkeys donated by the community just this morning. Sabu Sheikh Jr., who owns the Fish Hopper, dropped off 200 turkeys.
You know, it's something we've been doing all our lives, and it's just a great, great feeling to give back to our community. We have such a great community here on the Monterey Peninsula. Salvation Army is such a great organization, and what we donate goes directly to the people in need.
Representatives with the Salvation Army say they couldn't reach their goals without that kind of help. Over in Seaside at the Missionary Baptist Church, volunteers with the Coalition of Christian Churches packed up boxes of food to bring to shelters, filling 1,000 boxes with sweet potatoes, vegetables, stuffing, canned goods, and pumpkin pies. The boxes designed to feed a family of five. They started at 8 this morning and will be working into the evening to make sure everybody has what they need. We're told by officials there that in these tough times, they want to be there to help out those in need.